Yeah.
No need to worry about your newfound knowledge for your brand new life, which means more. Cause Hagins and power, you see that he has me. No need to worry about your newfound knowledge for your brand new life, which means more. Cause Hagins and power, you see that he has me.
Somebody told me Hagins' passion was strong. Yeah, I can see that. Said love for his people. Was long, yeah, I can feel that. Cause spitting knowledge, then the village was born. Hold on tight, we spitting fire tonight. Destroying lies, renewing lives like never before. He's teaching truth, withholding nothing, leaving you wanting more. He changed my life, uncovered truth that was written on walls. The hieroglyphs in ancient Egypt telling stories of all. Spent lonely nights teaching the fight while gripping on walls. He stands alone, not fearing nothing as he sits on the throne. Keep teaching knowledge, fearing nothing so that we stand tall. The 10th of giant, mighty hero, stacking this one for all, no doubt.
No need to worry about your newfound knowledge for your brand new life, which means more. Cause Hagins and power, you see that he has thee. No need to worry about your newfound knowledge for your brand new life, which means more. Cause Hagins and power, you see that he has thee.
Yo, I'm the type that like the scholars to shine. You've never seen a cat like this. His work is truly divine. This year, a dedication, he will always prevail. He chose this life for brand new ground here in the ATL. In Missouri, he continues to shine. Oh, ancient one, oh, can you hear me? This is Hagins High Time. Hop in the plane, flies through the air, walk in his shoes. Life will never be fair, no doubt. It's me, Omuda Kun, I'm vibing mighty and high. Gave me my name, ancestral time, we seeking truth, no more lie. CJ, I love your vocals, they're so silky and smooth. We compliment each other's sound, I see you making your moves.
That's right, CJ Afia with the vocals so smooth. Rocking the mic, wish I was there tonight with Omuda Kun.
That's right, we spit that fire, vibing mighty tonight. We pay great homage to the mighty as we slay on the mic, no doubt.
Don't need to worry about your newfound knowledge for your brand new life, which means more. Cause Hagins and power, you see that he has me. No need to worry about your newfound knowledge.
Oh, okay.
Your brand new life, which means more. Cause Hagins and power, you see that he has me.
Thank you, sisters. Thank you, sisters. Thank you, sisters. Thank you. My goodness. Queen CJ and Queen Omuda Kun. Thank you so much, sisters, for that presentation. Hey, guys, welcome to another Sunday online and NJIA Fellowship of the African Village and Cultural Center. I'm Ray Hagins, your teacher, your friend, your brother. Hey, man, let's get right into what we do, okay? And let's open up with one more time. And I mean, I want you guys to sing that today like you never sang it before, okay? I mean, you know, hey, one more time. A day that we cannot take for granted, okay? So let's do it. One more time, one more time. God allowed us to come together. One more time. One more time. One more time. Everybody, lift your voice with me. Come on. One more time, God allowed us to come together. One more time, God allowed us to come together. One more time, God allowed us to come together. One more time, God allowed us to come together. One more time, one more time, God allowed us to come together. God allowed us, yeah.
praise God's name. God allowed us to come together. To praise God's name. To praise her name. Yeah, yeah, God allowed us to come together. God allowed us, yeah. Oh, yeah. Just sing our song. Just sing our song. God allowed us, yes, he did, to come together. Sing our song. Sing our song. Sing our song. God allowed us to come together. God allowed us, yeah, yeah, to come together. Now put those hands together, come on, to clap our hands, everybody. To clap our hands. God allowed us to come together. To clap our hands. To clap our hands. Clap our hands. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah. To come together, clap our. God allowed us, yeah. Oh, yeah. To come together. Everybody say one more time. Just one more time. God allowed us to come together. Just one more time. One more time, yeah. One more time. Oh, God allowed us. Ah, God allowed us, yeah, yeah, yeah. God allowed us, yeah, yeah. Ah, to come together once again, y'all, yeah. God allowed us. God allowed us, y'all, yeah. God allowed us. Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Ah, oh, yes, he did. God allowed us. Yeah, yeah. God allowed us. God allowed us to come together. One more. Woo! One more time. One more time. God allowed us to come together. One more time. Let's go right on into the oath to the ancestors, okay? Lift your voices with me at this time. And the brothers and I, as we honor those who have gone before us, their life, their deeds, their legacy, their contributions, let's honor them by calling forth their names, remembering their lives at this time. Everybody, come on.
Oh, ancestors, blacker than a thousand midnights, African ancestors, it is to you that we, your children, give respect and honor. Oh, ancestors, we call upon you and welcome you in this place. African ancestors, let your presence fill this place. Oh, our ancestors, who have been purposely excluded from the history books
so that the world would not know of your great greatness.
Our African ancestors, who gave civilization to the world.
Yes,
our African ancestors, who gave the arts to the world.
Our African ancestors,
who gave music to the world.
Our African ancestors,
who gave the sciences to the world.
Our African ancestors,
who gave mathematics to the world.
Our African ancestors,
who gave medicine to the world.
Our African ancestors,
who gave the literature to the world.
Yes, 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 yes.
Our African ancestors,
yes.
Who gave philosophy to the world.
Oh, man, yeah.
Our African ancestors.
Our African ancestors.
Who gave God consciousness to the world.
Yeah, man.
Oh, ancestors.
We thank you for devoting your life to make a future for us.
Your children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren.
Now stand with us. Strengthen us. Guide us. Teach us. And protect us from the snare of our enemies. Rise up, O African ancestors, and let our enemies be scattered, and give us the wisdom and the boldness to deal with our oppressors and those who would hinder the liberation and empowerment of our people. Rise up, O African ancestors, and live in us, and we will not fail to honor you.
We will not fail to respect you.
Yeah, man.
We will not fail to hear you, and we will not betray you.
Our shame.
Oh, yes. Brothers and sisters, we want to take the time to honor just a few of the great Africans who have gone ahead of us. We call forth their great African names and honor them.
Yes.
To pharaohs Narmer, Zoja, Sneferu, Khufu, Khafre, Menkaure, and the great vizier and physician and multi-genius Imhotep, we say,
Ashe. Ashe.
To Queen Netopis,
ooh, yes,
Queen
Sebekneferu, yes.
Queen Ahotep, Queen
Amos, we honor your memory today.
Queen King Hatshepsut, Nefertiti, Queen T, and
right.
Queen Nefertari II, we say,
Ashe.
To Menkepin Ra Tahuti Maze, known as Thutmosis III, Amenhotep III,
Akhenaten,
Tutankhamun, Ursa Ma'at-Ra, Setepin Ra, Ramnetsu Meriamun, Ramses II, Shabaka, Taharqa, Hannibal, and the great African warrior Shaka Zulu, we say,
Ashe.
To all of the kings, queens, priests, and warriors of Nubia, Waset, Ethiopia, Kemet, Kenya, the Congo, Tanzania, Uganda, Central, South, and West Al-Kivu land, we say, Ashe. To the more than 600 million Africans whose lives were lost in the European invasions of Africa and in the Middle Passage, we say, Ashe. To the more than 300 million who have since lost their lives to racism and hate crimes, we say,
Ashe.
To Harriet Tubman,
Ashe.
Frederick Douglass,
Ashe.
Mary McLeod Bethune,
Ashe.
Nat Turner,
Ashe.
Fannie Lou Hamer,
Ashe.
Sojourner Truth,
Ashe.
Carter G. Woodson,
Ashe.
Booker T. Washington,
Ashe.
Dr. Charles Drew,
Ashe.
Noble Drew Ali,
Ashe.
Benjamin Banneker,
Ashe.
George Washington Carver,
Ashe. You can
Bishop
call
Richard
forth
Allen,
the names
Ashe.
Of
Bishop
ancestors
Charles Harrison
that you know
Mason,
of. Call their names
Thurman,
out.
Ashe. Mother Mahalia Jackson,
whoever they are, call
the
their names.
Marcus Messiah Garvey,
yes.
Benjamin E. May,
yes.
Langston Hughes,
yes.
Medgar Evers,
Elder Leroy
Paul
Jackson,
Robeson,
Ashe.
Dr. Martin Luther King,
Elder Coney White,
Malcolm X,
Ashe.
Thurgood Marshall,
Ashe.
Mother Clara Hale,
Mother Lily Phillips,
Adam Clayton Powell,
Ashe.
The Honorable Elijah Muhammad,
Ashe.
Dr. Amos Wilson,
Ashe.
Dr. John Henrik Clark,
Mitchell Carter
Pearson, Dr. John G. Jackson,
Ashe.
Dr. Shikanta Diop,
Ashe.
Dr. Chancellor
yes.
Williams,
Ashe.
Dr. George G.M. James,
Elder Ashe. Leon
Patrice
Stewart,
Lumumba,
Ashe.
Kwame yeah. Ture,
Ashe.
Kwame Nkrumah,
Ashe.
Dr. Khalid Muhammad,
yes.
Dr. Jacob Kuredu,
Ashe.
Dr. Ishaka Musa Badashango,
Ashe.
Brother Ray Charles,
Ashe. Ashe.
To our mothers and fathers,
Ashe. Daisy Raymond Higgins.
Our grandmothers and grandfathers,
Ashe. Ashe.
To our great grandmothers and great grandfathers,
yes, Mary Higgins.
Our brothers and sisters,
Ashe. Ashe.
Sons and daughters,
Ashe.
Aunts and uncles,
Ashe. Yes. Ashe.
Nieces,
Ashe.
Nephews,
Ashe.
Cousins,
Ashe. Ashe.
And all those who have gone ahead of
Ashe.
Us. And have made their ancestral transition to their life, deeds, legacy, and contributions, we say,
yeah,
Ashe. Again, we say,
Ashe.
Again, we say,
Ashe. Abel, join in with me at this time as we sing this wonderful praise.
Allahu Akbar.
Alhamdulillah. Yes, man, yes.
God is great, and he's worthy to be praised. I say hallelujah. God is great, and he's worthy to be praised. I say hallelujah, so God make us one. We all should be one, and then the unbelievers will come and say, you are with us. God make us one. We all should be one, and then the unbelievers will come and say, you are with us. God make us one. We all should be one,
And then the unbelievers will come and they will say, you are with us, yeah. Yeah. Alhamdulillah. Woo, man. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, which simply means in the Arabic tongue, God is great. Or God is the greatest. God is greater, however you want to say it. You know, whenever you translate from another language into English, trust me, you always lose something from that, you know. Oh, family, so good to have you guys with me once again today. I ask you to just, as much as possible, try to overlook my emotionalism. You know, sometimes I can be a big crybaby. Sometimes I think about, I grew up hearing about this prophet in the Bible, Jeremiah, and they called him the weeping prophet because when he would prophesy, he would start weeping, supposedly, but man never existed. But I exist, okay? And when I begin to talk about the wonderful things that's happening, you know, how awesome the Most High is, what's going on in my life, you know, how I can see the Most High at work in my life. The wonderful things that's just happening, man, I can't help it. It just brings forth tears of joy. You know, people say to me, man, how can you smile at a time like this? How can I not smile at a time like this? I mean, you know, listen, God has blessed me to see another day. Another day. Okay? Y'all just bear with me for a second while I do this, okay? I've been diagnosed, man, with, you know, trying to tell me I'm going to, come on, kidney disease, all this kind of foolishness. I haven't been sick. I haven't experienced pain. You follow what I'm saying? All this stuff that you're supposed to go through, I'm not going through any of that. You know, I haven't, let's put it this way, I haven't been through it. Okay, I'm still taking one day at a time. Okay, and people say, you're looking good. Thank you so much. And it's your prayers that's helping me do that. It's your energy that's helping me to do that. Brothers and sisters, let me tell y'all something before we go further into the program and honoring our those who are our supporters. I want to take a moment to say thank you to a very powerful dear brother. Many of you might have seen him on television. Okay, but he reached out to me the other day just to let me know that my teachings are making a difference in the world. And it means so much to me coming from a movie star, you know. Okay, and that's Brother Timon Durrett. I think he's the star of this this show on corner called Sugar something. Oh God, I can't think. What's wrong with my brain here? Okay, at any rate, y'all probably knew who I'm talking about. And the brother called. We had such a great time of fellowship talking, man. It was just wonderful, you know. And then the very next day, and Brother Timon and I talked on Friday. Right? Was it Friday? I'm so, y'all listen, bear with me. I'm just so lit up, man. I'm all carried away here. Okay. Let me get this right. Okay. Maybe it was Thursday. I don't know. Within the last 48 hours. Okay. I'm just messed up here. This is Sunday, right? This is Sunday morning. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. This is Sunday. Yeah. Okay. Friday, I was with another, that's right. Thursday, I was with Brother Timon. Friday, I was with a friend of mine that I've known for almost 50 years, right? We went to church together in New Jersey, Church of God in Christ. And she's been listening to me as well over the years. A couple of others from that home church has been listening to me. And I'm saying, wow, look at how the Most High is working here, you know? And so she called and she wanted her husband and I to meet, and we all met. And he also shared his experience with me of what he's going through. And I would like to dedicate today's program to them, okay? And that is my new brother from another mother and my sister. And then as Brother Daryl, okay? And Sister Renee, Carolyn Renee, oh God, Murray, okay? You know, I'm going to have to just start making a big cue sheet. Okay, I'm not young as I used to. I can't keep everything in my head. But
to Brother Daryl and Sister Renee, I want to thank you guys so very much. You guys have absolutely no idea how powerful the move of the Most High was on the other evening as we fellowshipped with each other. Thank you guys so much. Thank you. And thank you for continuing to support me with your prayers and what have you. Okay. We got a lot of work to do yet, you know, and you're going to be a part of it too. All right. Oh my goodness. Moving on to all of you who are members and supporters of the African Village and Cultural Center. Thank you so much to our brothers and sisters there in headquarters in St. Louis, to our elders there. Thank you for your support. Thank you for who you are. To our brothers and sisters of the first African Village that we formed after 9 years in existence, Youngstown, Ohio. To our elders there, to our brothers and sisters there in Ohio. Okay. Thank you for being who you are up there in Cleveland as well. Okay. To our brothers and sisters out into the Detroit area, okay, Chicago area, our brothers and sisters down in Columbia, South Carolina, African Village down there, New York City, okay, oh man, everywhere, and of course, Memphis, Tennessee, you know, to our supporters down in the Virgin Islands, and Guyana, South America, out there in the motherland, the various countries there, okay. Oh man, it's just so good. I am so honored. I'm so honored, man, to be able to do this, man. I'm so honored to be a vessel used by the Most High to touch a life. That's all I want to do. I don't want to be popular. I don't want to be rich. I don't want to be famous. Too much mess goes with all that stuff. I just want to make a difference in somebody's life with the truth. That's all I want to do. If I can do that one person at a time, you know, and you helping me with your support and your prayers, we'll make this thing happen, man. We'll make this thing. Those who have God have purposed to be delivered and liberated will be so because of our work. And when I say our, I don't mean my work. I mean our work together. Whoo, man. Mm-mm-mm. Well, brothers and sisters, before we get ready to go into our teaching for today, want to say by way of announcement, okay, that the class, the Bible study has been phenomenal, man. You know, tonight is our second session, okay, and many people have been asking, is it too late to join, okay? I'll tell you what I'll do. If you still want to be a part of it, okay, send me an email. I'll communicate back to you. But after this week, it will be too late to join the sessions, and I'll send you the makeup sessions, which is only two, okay? And come on and be a part of this class, okay? So if you want to be a part of it, all right, go on and send me an email letting me know, all right? Okay, and we'll get you enrolled. We still have I bought more seats because so many people was asking. So if you want to still be a part of it, you can, all right? And hopefully we've cleared up the problem that we had from last week. This week and forthwith, we'll be using Zoom. Okay, my own private room there in Zoom. So we won't have this problem, hopefully. All right, hopefully. Brothers and sisters, there was a young man, we had a minister in the African Village in St. Louis. His name was Brother, now he's still with us. His name is Brother Philip Simmons, you know. And this was one of the most awesome young brothers I'd ever met in my life. Okay. And there, I have my reasons for saying that. He was a very challenged young brother. He didn't have the opportunities that a lot of us have, you know, and that's one of the things that made him so dear to us, you know. And Philip is going to open up the teaching today with a presentation that he did, a spoken word presentation. Okay. And after him, we'll go into the message. All right. So let's hear Philip at this time. Yeah, buddy. Let's hear the brother. Okay.
Ask if Minister Simmons will come just before I do and present a piece that he did on Friday night in the spoken word cafe session. And we had a great time here on Friday night. Those who missed it, you missed a treat. And our brother put together, this brother got an awesome mind. He just stood flat-footed and dropped this thing. It was so good and heavy. And I said, brother, we need to have that recorded so I can put that on Black Liberation Radio. So I'm going to ask if he will come at this time. And let's receive our brother. All right, put your hands together for our own minister, Philip Simmons. Come on, brother. What's up, brother?
permission from the believers to speak. I give honor to the one true and living God, our ancestors, each of you in your respective places, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, friends and others. I greet you with the African village's greeting words of peace, Ma'a Hotel. For those of you who have come out tonight, today, for those of you who have come all the way across town to be in this place, know that you have made the right choice. You are in the right place at the right time, because the African village is definitely set up to put something on your African mind. Whether that thing comes in word or song, by the time you leave here today, you're going to know we got it going on. I am honored to have this privilege to be able to come and share that what Almighty God has put up on my heart. In the biblical fabrication, located in the third chapter of the book of Ecclesiastes, it talks about a time and a season. You are the people of African descent. And I wanted to pose a question to you this morning. Do you know what time it is? Think about that. Let it get in your mind. Marinate in your heart. Do you know what time it is? Because if you really understood and knew what time it is, then why do you walk around with your head hung down? Why is it every time we see those of African descent on their face is a frown? What's wrong with African people's mind? Why is everybody making progress, but we seem to be lagging so far behind?
Come on, Minister.
This piece is entitled, Uplift Your Head.
Yes, sir.
Our time has come. Uplift your head. Our time has come. Our ancestors warned us time and time again. They warned us about this nation and her wicked plan. They warned us about leaving our future into the hands of this white man. But so many of us did not want to hear, nor did we respect what our ancestors had to say. So we turned up our nose, we turned our back, and we looked the other way. But now everything they told us, it is right now all up in our face. The black man and woman of America is in a hell of a condition.
Yes, sir.
And as a people, we have fallen in disgrace. This enemy's wickedness has clutched us. It has froze many of us in our tracks. Like a boxer, we've been hit with a left hook and left lying on our back. Blind, deaf, dumb, crazy as hell. Walking around in this delusional state, living like we're under a serious spell. And after 453 years of this madness, I just cannot understand why we keep putting our faith and trust in the same old man. It is about time that we open our eyes and get it through our head and recognize all over America this white man want us dead.
We don't have that role to play. And I know that's hard for you, the masses, to understand. Because so many of you done got caught up so deep into the world of this white man. But for those of you who are conscious, for those of you who really understand, for those of you who have freed your mind, for those of you who have a plan, uplift your head, beloved, and know that our time has come. All over America, I hear the beat of the African drums. I hear the voice of our ancestors in my ear every day, calling us back to the principles of Ma'a, calling us back to the African way. Uplift your head and free your mind. Grab hold of this message while you yet have time. For the message of liberation is here, and is here to stay.
Yeah.
To show you and I of African descent a more excellent way. Uplift your head and open your eyes. Accept your own and be yourself. Then again, you can rise. Uplift your head, I said, for our time has come. All over America, I hear the beat of the African drums. I hear the voice of our ancestors in my ear every day, calling us back to the principles of Ma'a, calling us back to the African way. And now that your head has been lifted, and now that you have once again become a man, stand up in America and carry out the plan. And as you carry out the plan, know that unity is important. Know that right knowledge is needed. Know if the believers stick together, we can never be defeated.
Minister Philip Simmons. When the queen mother of the village, when Mom Phillips says, "Yes, sir," it's all right then, yes, ma'am. I'll be looking for that, I tell you. Oh, come on, let's put our hands one more time. Put our hands together one more time for our brother. Oh, brother, I tell you. Yes, buddy. Powerful, powerful, powerful. Once again, before getting into our message for today, I'd like to say to those of you who have come from such a great distance to be with us, thank you for coming. To our family from Ohio, we love you guys. With all our hearts, man, we love you, we love you, we love you. Brother Baba to Rudo, thank you for coming, brother. You know, and thank you so very much for the vision that you have. And of course, to our African family right here, thank y'all for coming right from around the corner. Thank y'all for coming from across town. You know, thank you for your being here today. The message that I have to share with you today, family, is entitled "The Application of Knowledge." The application of knowledge. I'd like to begin this message by reading from the sacred text of the Hosea, from the particular book known as the oldest scriptures in the world, and that is the book of Ptahotep. On page 41 in the Hosea, section 1, it reads like this: "Be not arrogant because of your knowledge." Now, believe it or not, I've already preached. That's it right there. Be not arrogant because of your knowledge. Or you can replace the word knowledge with these two words, acquired information. Okay. Take counsel with the ignorant as well as with the wise. Okay. For the limits of knowledge in any field, yes, have never been set. And no one has ever reached them. Wisdom is rarer than emeralds, and yet it is found among the women who gather at the grindstones. The application of knowledge. When I look at our condition as Africans living in America, it is almost impossible for me to separate the unique form of indoctrination into this global enslavement that we suffer. We've been colonized, and there is an ongoing exploitation of Africans in this capitalistic economy in which we live. We have been indoctrinated into the suppression of our own consciousness. Did y'all grab that? I want to take my time, and I got so much heavy stuff I want to say. I want to say it slow so that you can chew on it as I'm saying. We have been indoctrinated into the suppression of our own consciousness. Our community is in a state of mental deprivation. Our community is in a state of spiritual deprivation. Our community is in a state of socioeconomic deprivation. Then to top it off, there is the blinding propaganda of patriotism. Black folk who are out of their minds have a stupid kind of patriotism to a country and a government that cares absolutely nothing whatsoever about them. The media has played with our minds to the point to where as we think that it is a source of truth, when we need to understand that it is the vehicle of manipulation of the powers that be. What's really deep about it, y'all, is we have this confusion over a loyalty to an oppressor. And the reason why we have this loyalty is because we have been duped into thinking that the origin of racism was slavery. Y'all following me? We have literally been duped into thinking that racism began with slavery. Nothing can be farther from the truth. And you'd be surprised how many Europeans even think that racism began with slavery. Everybody say this: I must understand, say it, the cause of my predicament.
the understanding of cause is of utmost importance. If you don't understand the cause of a thing, you will never ever address it. Too many people scrape paint off of the ceiling in their house because it's peeling, and they paint over it. A few months later, they scrape it again and paint over it. A few months later, they scrape it again and paint over it, never stopping to think that there must be a cause to this paint that keeps peeling. Until you get up and fix the leak in the roof, you're gonna always keep on scraping, peeling paint. Once you understand, family, that racism and cultural supremacy preceded the enslavement of Africans in the Americas, then you come to the fact that the only solution, everybody say, the only solution. The only solution, brothers and sisters, for our predicament is for us to change the framework of the color hierarchies through which people have learned to judge one another. People have learned to screen one another as well as every other aspect in their world. You've got to change the framework that causes you to think the way you do. We got black folk who honestly operate within a framework that the lighter your skin, the better you are. Look at somebody near you and say, there's something wrong with that. We got to get rid of that kind of thinking. Without a working appreciation of our cultural and historical heritage to the historically demonstrated intent of others, we cannot remain competitive. We cannot remain operative in this society. We don't love ourselves like we're supposed to. We don't appreciate ourselves like we're supposed to. We have an appreciation for everybody else but us. Y'all heard about the recent doll test all over again? Where a young black child is given the opportunity to choose between a white doll and a black doll. And that black child chooses the white doll. Something's wrong with that. And then what's really deep is when the child is challenged, the child says, the white doll is good. The black doll is bad. Then when the instructor asks the child, what color are you? The child went into cognitive dissonance. Yes. And became unable or unwilling to answer the question. We must understand, family. Now, I don't mean to hurt anybody's feelings today. I meant to say that at the top. For the sake of visitors, I don't mean no harm. But I don't pull punches over here at the African Village. Because I'm trying to set us free. I'm trying to wake us up. That's the problem now. We've been stroked to sleep. We've been comforted till we're sleeping to our own demise. So let me smack you today. I gotta wake you up. We must understand, family, that integration
is the enemy of African unity. Did y'all hear what I said? Integration is the enemy of African unity. Why do you say that, Pastor Ray? Because integration requires that the integrating group be subsumed. I didn't say consumed. I said subsumed. Integration requires that the integrating group be weakened. Integration requires that the integrating group be scattered as a minority in a society where the majority rules. Integration, or the amalgamation of the races, I don't care how you want to say it, are exercises in fatalism and wishful thinking, and we're good at that. We're good at wishing the best. We live our lives wishing for the best. Cedric told us how we like to wish. Cedric the Entertainer, he said, black folk or those folks, I wish I would sit in my seat. We are a wishing kind of people. Why is integration bad? Follow this very carefully, people. Integration is bad because, and just look back at history. Let history testify for me today. There has never been a time in the history of the human race where the slave masters or the oppressors of one group ever voluntarily let the other group have equal opportunity. Think about it. Well, the Lord wants us all to be one. The people who say that don't mean that. What they mean is the Lord wants you black folk to be subsumed into the program of the European mind. Brothers and sisters, for the sake of our empowerment and for the sake of our liberation, we must stop. Yeah, can I be free now? Yes, sir. All right. We must stop confusing intellectual masturbation with African consciousness. Did y'all grab that? Let me say it again. We've got to stop confusing intellectual masturbation with African consciousness. Now, what do you mean, Pastor Ray, when you say intellectual masturbation? You've heard me say that before, but I never defined it for you. So that we're clear today, let me define what I mean. Intellectual masturbation is what I call the Western or the European concept of consciousness. You see, the European concept of consciousness embraces and advocates intellectualization for the sake of rationalizing despiritualized concepts. Did y'all get that? Let me say it another way for you. Intellectual masturbation is really, really about expressing acquired information just so that you will sound like you got it together. But in reality, you ain't got nothing together. That's what intellectual masturbation is. We got folk walking around with all this information up here. All these
books up under their arm, but their life is absolutely powerless, non-productive. They are an insult to the African community. There's nothing as bad, y'all. There's nothing as bad as for you to look like you got it together. And then when you open your mouth, you are a complete disappointment to everybody. So now, what is consciousness? Consciousness is a state of mind. That's what consciousness is. It is a state of mind. It is an evolution in your thinking to the point to where you have the power to actualize your testimony. Let me say it again. I'll say it first this way. If you can't actualize your testimony, you ain't doing nothing but talking loud and saying nothing. If you cannot actualize what you say you're about, you ain't able to do a thing. If you can't actualize your testimony, you can't help the community. I think you need to preach that to your neighbor. Say, if you can't actualize your testimony, you can't help our community. I'm tired of seeing folk running their mouth. Y'all understand what I'm saying? I'm serious. As my teacher and our ancestor warrior, Dr. John Henry Clark, said it, he said, I'm weary of black people with their so-called knowledge. I'm weary of folk running their mouth and don't do anything. The scribes of our ancient African past, the scholars, the griots of our ancient African traditional greatness, pursued knowledge. Right. But they did not pursue knowledge for self-grandeur. They pursued knowledge to enhance the life of the community. Everything that they researched, all of the energy that they put into acquiring right knowledge was for the benefit of the community. Not for egotistical opportunities. And for millennia, the principles of my art governed their behavior. Therefore, from an African-centered perspective, we must understand that information itself, by default, must be actualized. There must be an acting out of awareness gained through the study, or there is no true consciousness. When I say the application of knowledge, I mean, let me see what you've learned. Don't let me hear what you've learned. Let me see what you've learned. Now, actually, y'all, what I'm saying to you, I heard this as a child in the Church of God in Christ. See, we sometimes throw our African spirituality away like everything that's in the church around. No. The principle that I was taught as a child in the Pentecostal church was this: be ye doers of the word, not just hearers only. Can I get a witness? That's what they taught us. Stop running your mouth. Do it. Stop trying to impress folk. Just do it. Ain't there things that just do it? Nike? Nike, just do it.
Somebody say the need,
for correcting
cultural education. I got to touch on this before I close. Due to the severity of menticide among our people. Now, how many of y'all know what menticide is? All right, I don't see any hands hardly. Okay, let me help. How many of y'all know what homicide is? All right, that's when you kill another human being, right? All right. How many know what fratricide is? That's when you kill a brother, right? Okay, how many know what suicide is? All right, maybe hear me straight up. That's when you kill yourself, right? Well, so you'll understand, family, menticide has to do with the killing of the mind. We suffer from a severe case of menticide. And it must be realized and accepted that empowerment through enlightenment will not be accomplished during this generation. Let me say it again. Empowerment through enlightenment will not be accomplished in this generation for us as a people as a whole. In fact, I'm going to be honest with you. It might not happen for the next few generations. Right. Brother Ray, what are you saying? Are you saying that there's no hope? No, I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying that you need to be realistic in your thinking. Brothers and sisters, you just heard this, brother. How many years did you say, brother, for 453 years? For 453 years, we have been misled. Actually, that's since being in this country. We've actually been misled over 2,000 years since the European invasions of Africa in 332 BC. We have been misled for millennia. Don't you think for one moment that because you have learned a little bit, that you are going to walk out of here and reverse what has taken hundreds of years, a couple of thousand years to create. But look at the person next to you and say, but we got to start somewhere. It's got to start right now with you. You have got to become an agent, a vessel, a voice in the wilderness of ignorance. You've got to open your mouth like I was taught in the church. Cry loud, spare not, lift up your voice like a trumpet in Zion and show my people their transgression. Now we got that all turned around. We think that means show my people that they're drinking too much. That's not the transgression, family. Show my people that they're staying out too late at night. That's not the transgression. The transgression of our people is turning away from who we are. The transgression of our people is taking on a belief system that is against us. The transgression of our people is loving an enemy. That taught you to pray for him instead of whipping his behind. Me, family, think with me. What better method of security for the enemy than for the enemy to put it in a book? Love your enemies. Pray for them that would mistreat you. When the very person who's mistreating you is the one who told you to pray for those who mistreat you. Look at somebody next to you and say, you better wake up. Realizing the struggle is the motivational force behind the African genius. You have to realize you're at war, family. It ain't just going to come to you. You got to wake up and get involved. You got to wake up and understand that there's a power out here that don't want your child to grow up. You got to wake up and understand that there's nobody that's going to stop this power but you. Come on, man. If somebody's trying to break in your house and destroy your family, what you going to do? Say, praise the Lord. I don't think so. You, with all your praise the Lord, you're going to find a bat, a stick, a something. You're going to find something to bust somebody's head open. Can I get a witness? Well, let me tell you, someone is breaking into our house. Someone has already broken into our house. They're raping our women. They're turning out our children. Yeah, buddy. And we still asking the Lord to come do something about it. God is speaking to you, saying, don't ask me to come do something, you do something. God is saying, I ain't got no hands but yours. I ain't got no feet but yours. So if a foot is going to be put somewhere, you need to start putting your foot there. Y'all all right? Don't get me wrong. I ain't preaching violence. I'm a non-violent kind of a guy. Until I see you trying to hurt me. Once I see you trying to hurt me, you're behind in trouble. Yeah, buddy. I can't stand there and let you hurt my kids. I can't stand there and let you hurt our women. You follow me? I don't care what color you are. I can't stand there and let you hurt the family. You got me? We got to get busy, family. There's a need for culture correcting education. I just told y'all it's going to take a few generations to correct the messed up mentality among our people. Therefore, we must understand that no permanent empowerment can take place until we implement an educational program that will successfully increase the level of consciousness from one generation to the next. Now, notice how I said that. I said no permanent empowerment. We experience 5 minutes of power and think we've arrived. Y'all follow what I'm saying? Simply because we've had a good day or because things went well for us this week, we think that we have arrived. That is not permanent empowerment. In fact, that you might have just got a good night's sleep.
Right?
Somebody might have walked up to you and asked you out on a date, and you think that we're on our way to victory as a people because you ain't been out in a while. Okay. Oh. Look at the person next to you and say a good night out. Is not permanent empowerment. I just felt something. Look back at him and say, it might be permanent problems, though. Never know. We can never correct this cycle of menticide without properly educating our young people. Did y'all hear what I said? And then not only them, we must properly educate their children. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. And I've often used this analogy in referring to the individual when making their transition from religion to African consciousness. But now I want this example to apply to our liberation. Suppose I have a glass with dirty water in it.
Come on, man.
And this water represents our menticide. Mm-hmm. It would be fatal for us to dump the dirty water out of the glass.
Mm-hmm. Right, come on.
Because then we would be mindless.
That's right.
You follow what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
And a mindless individual is just as dangerous, if not more dangerous, than a person with a mind that's dead. So what should we do? The glass represents the community of the black collective. What we need to do, family, is see to it that we take the glass of the African diaspora and put it up underneath a steady stream of water coming out of the faucet of Ma'at. Follow what I'm saying? And let that clean water go into the glass until the dirty water, which represents our menticide, begins to dilute and dilute and dilute and dilute, and eventually we will be healed as a people. But again, that is not going to happen in this generation. Understand what I'm saying to you. I will be dead when what I'm talking about happens to us on a collective. But it's got to start. When are we going to ever put the water up under the faucet? The glass up under the faucet. When are we going to ever do it? If we don't do it now. Our children need us. Any attempt, hear what I'm saying, and I hope I'm not sounding defeatist, but I'm trying to sound realistic. Any attempt for the liberation and empowerment of our people will fail unless we have the participation of black men and black women who are consciously about the business of ensuring the right environment for our children.
Yes, sir.
Did y'all get it?
Yes, sir.
See, some things I need to know that you got it. And that's why I repeat some things. Let me say it another way. If we ain't serious,
right.
Okay? If we just up here running our mouths, going through the form of coming to the village, one more time, he allowed us, he allowed us, he allowed us. If that's all you're about, everything we're doing will fail. Until we, black men and black women, organize ourselves and put something in place that will provide the proper environment for our children. If that doesn't happen, what we're doing will fail. Our black women and black men cannot do what I just said until we properly educate ourselves. Follow what I'm saying. Steve Coakley, awesome warrior scholar brother, who really tells it like it is. Steve said this: I'll know when you got right knowledge, because it will be manifested in your actions. You got me? If you don't have right knowledge, if you don't have liberation consciousness, you will continue to look good. You will continue to impress others, but your child will die. Where's that passage in Hosea? Who got their Bible? Hosea, what is it? My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. What is that passage? Hosea 4 and 6. Read it for me, Sister Karen, please, real quick. I want you, see, we focus on just that verse. I want y'all to hear something here.
My people are destroyed.
My people are destroyed, or my people are dying.
For lack of knowledge.
Because they're ignorant. Go ahead.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
Check this now.
I will.
Wait a minute, whoa. I sent knowledge. That's the thing I like about the Creator. The Creator is never, ever going to allow us to go without the opportunity of reception.
That's right.
The Creator is going to send you a messenger. You can count on it.
Yes.
I'm not the first one to come along, and I'm not going to be the last one. Just one of many messengers that the Creator sends for us to stop being ignorant. But when the Creator sends messengers, guess what we do? We reject the message. We reject the knowledge that's coming to us. So it says, because you have rejected knowledge, what is it going to say, sister?
I will also reject thee.
I will reject you.
Yes.
Go ahead.
That thou shalt be no priest to me.
Oh, my God. You're supposed to be in the position to heal my people. But you've rejected knowledge. So I'm going to make you an enemy to yourself. Man. Go ahead, sister. What else is that?
Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God.
Check this out now. Seeing that you have forgotten, you have chosen to forget who you are. You have chosen to forget the way of your ancestors, and you've taken on a way from Europe, from Italy, from Rome. You've chosen to take on a way that is anti-black. Because you've chosen, because you have refused to remember, what is it going to say?
I will also forget thy children.
Wow. I will also forget thy children. Now that sounds kind of cruel on God's part, doesn't it? It sounds kind of cruel that God would say, because you have forgotten the law of your ancestors and the laws of your ways, I will also forget your children. Brothers and sisters, who is God? I know some of y'all, you got a problem grabbing that. See, I told you we got to get there. We got to stop looking out there. Okay? We got to start looking in here. We got to start praying or thinking in here. God says, supposedly in this verse, because you have forgotten God, maybe I should say this, because you have forgotten who God is, you will lose the ability to be God in your life. Y'all ain't grabbing what I'm saying. Y'all ain't grabbing this. As a result of looking to a fake entity to give you power against the adversary, when the adversary attacks you and your home and your family and your children and your finances, you will be defenseless because you're depending on a lie to save you. Y'all all right? Brothers and sisters, an African cultural consciousness struggle has always been viewed as a good and necessary part of life. And not something to be feared, not something to be abhorred. Our ancestors were quite aware, and notice how it says in the ancient African proverb, limited struggle produces limited people. Limited struggle produces limited people. What is it that makes you strong? Pressure. Struggle. I may have told you about the story with the man who had a stone in the back of his house, giant stone. I don't know if I've told y'all about that. For those who haven't heard it, here's how it goes. This man went and bought a house one day, and he was riding down the street, and this is, of course, a story now. Learn the lesson in the story. Riding down the street, and the Spirit of God spoke to him and said, buy that house. Saw a for sale sign on it. So the Spirit said, buy that house. And so he bought the house. And then after he bought the house, he went out back, and there was this big stone right outside the back door. And he said, God, why would you have me buy a house with this big stone at the back door? So God said, push against the stone. Man said, what? Push against the stone. So okay. So the man got out there and started pushing. And he's just pushing against the stone, man. You know, he pushed and the stone ain't moving. God, the stone ain't moving. Keep on pushing. So he went around the other side. God, this stone ain't moving, man. Just keep pushing. All right, God, because you said so. And this went on for about 3 weeks. And then the dude said, God, I ain't pushing no more. You told me to push and move this stone, and I ain't moving. God said to him, I didn't tell you to move it. I told you to push against it. Now, God, why would you just have me push against the stone and it ain't moving? God spoke back to him. I didn't intend for the stone to move. I knew the stone was there when I told you to buy this house. The reason why I had you push against the stone was to make you stronger. Look at your arms. They're bigger because you've been pushing against that stone. You see what I'm saying? So a lot of times we got a stone in our lives. Circumstances, situations in our lives, and we're trying to push to get the thing going, and it's there to make you stronger, not for you to move it. Am I clear? You gotta have struggle, man. Struggle tempers a man or a woman for even more difficult challenges. A lot of people don't want no trouble. Right. Look at the person nearest you and say, if you avoid adversity, it will only weaken you. Let me say it again. If you avoid adversity, it will only weaken you. Are y'all grabbing this? Yes, see, I know we don't want to go through nothing. Right. We don't want to go through nothing. And that's why you can't take nothing. Soon as you hear something, you want to, yeah. You know, you got to get to the point, man, to where it's whatever comes your way. You say, all right, God is. When you grow to that point, you realize that a mountaintop ain't really a mountaintop. You realize that a valley ain't really a valley. Whatever point you are on the level, if it's up here or down here, it's where you're supposed to be at that time. Okay, y'all, you got this? So don't get happy when you're up here. Stay cool. Because tomorrow you're going to be down here. See, and that's the thing. Once you, if you learn to stay cool, no matter where you are, you'll be all right. Okay? But if you start up here, hey, I'm on the mountain top day. I'm in the valley now. That's how your life is going to be, up and down, up and down, up and down. After a while, you realize that it's just life.
Mm-hmm.
So, family, stand up. Be strong.
Yes.
Hold your African head up.
Yes, sir.
Walk tall. When I was in the Marines, we used to march and do drill. And drill instructor used to say, lean back and strut. Many Marines in here know what I'm talking about? There you go, brother. We used to march. You know what I mean? And man, you ain't walk like this. No, that wasn't it. When you marched, brother, you stood back, shoulders back. And when you marched, that's how you marched. Lean back and strut. Pick them up, put them down. No matter what's coming at you, you walk a certain way. Walk tall, walk proud, because you are a black warrior. Male or female, you are a black warrior. You are aware of your LOS in the army of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
That's why our folks would sing, I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Got my war clothes on in the army. So now I woke up and I started singing. Oh, I tell you, boy, it's amazing how that happens to me. Chosen us. Our ancestors are guiding us. And our children are counting on us. Ashe.
Ashe. Yeah, man, our children are counting on us. Oh, I trust that you got something out of that message, family. The application of knowledge. Yeah, man, wow. Mm-mm-mm. I've been blessed today being with you and you with me as we come together every week in fellowship. Oh, my goodness. Spread the message. Spread the message. Spread the message. Now, listen, we're getting ready to come back tonight for those of you who have enrolled in this biblical study and analysis of the biblical perspective. Okay. We're coming back tonight at 7 o'clock. Okay. Eastern Standard Time. The room will open up at 6:30. Okay, to give you time to get in there, get situated, come on into the classroom, come on in and get settled in, and you can have, you know, be sharing, talking with other people till class, till the teaching starts at 7 on the dot. Okay, the room will close 15 minutes after we start. So at 7:15, you will not be able to get into the room at 7:16 and thereafter. Okay, please understand that. Brothers and sisters, we're having such a wonderful time. Okay, with everything that's happening, I want to share with you guys this before we get out of here now, okay? If those of you who are watching me there on YouTube, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, so that when I do go live, you'll know it, all right? My email address, as you see on the screen there, is rayhagins@gmail.com. All right, now that's how you're going to communicate with me. I don't do the telephone thing, all right? That's too much talking, all right? Email me. And those of you who, and I, listen, please, everybody, I can't stress that enough. In all of your communication to me, hear me well, in all of your communication to me, those of you who are making your donations and sending in checks and money orders, okay, to help support this ministry and this work, please include your email address. Okay, somewhere in there. You know why I'm not saying that? So that I can send you an email saying thank you. Okay, it's too much trying to go to the post office. You know, we're on a whole different norm now. Okay, everything is right here electronically at your fingertips. Okay, that's why people don't hardly go to libraries no more, because of the internet. Follow me? So come on, let's come on up to speed. If you're sending me any kind of communication, what if it's just a question, still include your email address. Please get in the habit of that. Get in the habit of including your email address. Okay. I also encourage you, family, to log on and listen to me teaching 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at our website. Go to theafricanvillage.org, theafricanvillage.org. Click that big play arrow that's halfway down the page, and you'll hear me teaching, All right. Want to learn? Come on and go to school. Doesn't cost you anything. Okay. Yeah, man. All right. Let's continue on by talking about this now. All right. What does that mean? Your donations. Those of you who are supporting our work, I want to say, take a moment to, I don't have the words to let you know how much I appreciate you supporting our work, believing in what I'm doing. You know, I mean, that's deep, man. You know, that's deep, you know, and what means even more is when you tell me, man, I went and did the research and found out that you were telling the truth. That means so much. That means so much, you know. So I thank you guys for just hanging on in there, man, and supporting the work and enforcing the work. I appreciate that. Those of you making your donations, please feel free to make your donations accordingly. If you're making your donation through PayPal, you see the address there. Our donation address at PayPal is AfricanVillage1@AOL.com. That's African with a K, not a C. AfricanVillage1@AOL.com. If you're making your donation through Cash App, as you see it there, it's #Dr. Ray Hagins. Okay. Now, for those of you who make your donation through Cash App, our Cash App account is attached to the Lamplight Group. Follow what I'm saying. It's not attached to the African Village. Okay. And why is that? Because the Lamplight Group is my company that does all of our media development. Follow what I'm saying? Okay. DVDs, recordings. Anytime we have to do a gig for doing sound something for people, you know, that's the Lamplight Group. That's another arm altogether. Okay, so if you make your donation to Dr. Ray Hagins at Cash App, #Dr. Ray Hagins, you may see the Lamplight Group. If you see that, don't be alarmed. It's still me. Okay, if you're making your donation through Zelle, please send it to my email address, rayhagins@gmail.com. For those who are still mailing in your donations, or if you we notice the change of address now, okay, and Brother Walter Winston, thank you, man. I got it. All right, if you hear me talking to you, and I miss you so much, brother. I miss y'all, man. Okay, I'm not going to get sorry. All right, yeah, yeah. But thanks, brother. I'm saying that to let you know that I know you saw the change of address because we did get your donation. Okay, thank you, man. Notice the new address, 863 Flat Shoals Road, Southeast, Suite number 242, Conyers, Georgia, 30094. Write that down and keep it handy, okay? Write that down and keep it handy, yes. Okay, we thank you again, family, for how you've continued to make this work happen. You know, couldn't do it without you. It's just that simple, man. I can't do it without you. All right. Okay, and of course, we can't leave now without talking about this great organization, right? The Black Achievement Fund. Yeah, I'm so proud to be a part of this group, man. You know, young people doing something. Young people. I'm the elder of the group. Okay. I'm the elder, man. Ain't that deep? These young people have come together. You know, and okay. In fact, I'm gonna try to get it done this week. I'm gonna get with Brother Arkee and see if we can run down to where we just brought Acres. I forgot how much he think he did. I forgot what he said. I don't want to quote him wrong, so I'll just wait till I come back with the report. We just purchased acres of land so that we can build upon it, okay, and have our own facilities, have our own center, have our own medical. You understand what I'm saying? That's the vision, man. You know, we're putting up A-frame homes, you know, so people can live out there. All right. Yeah. All for $9 a month. That's why we're trying to tell you. $9 a month. Come on, man. Join the Black Achievement Fund so that we can have our own. All right. $9 a month, man. I forgot. I still got this picture up here. Could have been passing the picture on so y'all can see, right? Okay. Come on. Black Achievement Fund. All right, BAF.solutions, that's the website. Go there, BAF.solutions, okay, and join the Black Achievement Fund. $9 a month. When you join, they're going to send me an email, and they're going to ask when you join. They're going to say, how did you hear about us? Okay, so how have you heard about them? If it's from another BAF member, put it there. But if you heard about them from Dr. Ray Hagins, right here on the air, say from Dr. Ray, they're going to send me an email letting me know that you joined. When I get that email from them, I'm going to send an email to you, okay? Welcoming you to the Black Achievement Fund. Brothers and sisters, I'm having so much fun living my life. I don't have time to think about what life would be like if this were to happen, if that were to, I don't believe in imaginary obstacles. Write that down. imaginary obstacles. Wow, so many of you, I gotta say this, I'm just led to say it. Some of you watching me right now, your life is at a standstill. Let me get this out the way because I'm done with that. Your life is at a standstill because of imaginary obstacles, things that are not even real, things that are not true, but they're in your mind of what might happen if you take a chance to do this. What might go wrong? Brothers and sisters, stop that. Just stop it. That's what's been holding you back. Get rid of that thinking, okay? And I guess somebody needed that right there at that moment because I'm getting ready to go off now, okay? So come on and close out with us by lifting your voice together, singing The African in Me Loves the African in You. And when we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. You know why? Because you're easy to love. So come on, family, sing that with me at this time, maybe as we get out of here, all right? Yeah. Hey. Ain't nothing we can't do. Yeah. Come on, everybody. Yeah.
African in me, love the African in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. African in me, love the African in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. You're easy. You are so easy. You're so easy. You're easy to love. Yeah. The African in me loves the African in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. Yeah. The African in me loves the African in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. You're easy. You're easy. You're so easy. Yeah, yeah. Easy to love.
The principles of art, the truth that's in me, love the truth that's in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. No, truth that's in me, love the truth that's in you. Yeah, when we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. You're easy. We're gonna make it, brother Darrell. You're easy. We got to make it. You're easy. You're easy to love. Justice, come on. Justice in me, love and justice in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. Justice in me, love and justice in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. 'Cause you're easy. You're easy. You are so easy. You're easy to love. Righteousness, come on. The righteousness in me, love the righteousness in you. Yeah, when we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. Oh, the righteousness in me, love the righteousness in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. You're easy. You know I see you laughing, right, Jackie? You're easy. You know I see you laughing. You're easy. Laughing at me dancing, I know it. You're easy to love. Woo! Woo! Righteousness in me, love the righteousness in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. The righteousness in me, love the righteousness in you. When we come together, ain't nothing we can't do. 'Cause you're easy. You are so easy. You are so easy. Yeah. You're easy to love. You're easy to love. Everybody, you're easy to love. Wow. Family, I
I've enjoyed being with you guys today. I've enjoyed being with y'all so much. I'm telling you, man, thank you so much for being with me. And I pray that you were blessed by the teaching today. Let's share it, okay? Don't keep it to yourself. Share the video. Share that link with as many people as you can. That's how we get the message out, okay? Until next week, you guys out there, continue to stay strong. And I'll see you guys then, all right?